I'm JJ Voss. I'm a roots rock artist from Western Canada. I grew up about an hour north of Regina on a small farm, and small town where I was from, sports was kind of the thing, but I figured out at an early age that I wasn't very good at any of them. So I got into music at a pretty young age, and I've been chasing that dream ever since. In my career right now, I have just released my third album back in March of 2020, right around the time that the pandemic hit. But we've been working it hard, doing everything that we can to keep the wheels turning, and it's going as well as can be expected, really. Success to me, it means getting up in the morning and not hating going to work. There's many weeks that there's not enough hours in the day, and when Friday afternoon comes, I wish there was more time. So at that point, when you don't hate your job, when you look forward to getting up in the morning and going to it, I think that is success. I suppose the best story that I could share with you, or the best gigs I've ever done, there isn't just one. There would have to be a few different instances. Of course, I've played some shows in front of 10,000 people, which was an adrenaline rush that you can't beat. But there are other shows that when you get with a small, intimate crowd, and they're hanging on your every word, and they're picking up what you're putting down, and they're getting the message of your songs, that's the reward for me, and that's why I do what I do. So, I don't know if there's one answer for that. Of course, you love the great big shows, but sometimes the most rewarding ones are the intimate ones where you really connect with your audience.
He don't take the short way home when the bell rings after school. It's a different route every day. Survival is the rule. Sometimes it's out behind the monkey bars or that spot behind the gym. A time or two he stood his ground when they caught up to him. It's that same old helpless feeling. Just another day. He don't see an ending to the game he's gotta play. That's what you do when you grow up black and blue. Look him in the eye and tell him things are gonna change. When you know too well around here it's always been this way. And when you brew so deep you just can't help but learn. And you wait your turn. Now these days things are different, and he's got all the friends. He's filled out, he's found his voice, now they don't mess with him. Now he's the star out on the football field, and a big guy in the gym. When that bell rings, I do my best to not run into him. It's that same old helpless feeling. Just another day, another generation. Don't know no other way. That's what you do when you grow up black and blue. Look him in the eye and tell him things are gonna change. When you know too well around here it's always been this way. When you brew so deep you just can't help but learn. And you take your turn. It's what you do when you grow up black and blue. Hey! tell him things are gonna change. When you know too well round here, it's always been this way. When you bruise so deep, you just can't help but learn. When you take your turn, it's nothing new. When you grow up black and blue, a tough pill to chew. When you grow up black and blue, it's just what you do. When you grow up black and blue.
Black and Blue came from a personal experience. It was basically how I grew up in a small town. I wasn't all that popular in elementary school. I wasn't good at any of the sports, and I got a pretty rough ride at a young age. But then I wound up, as I got older, I kind of came into my own and found my own thing, and I wound up passing along the same bad behavior to the next generation of kids. And I didn't even know, but I became part of the problem. I thought that was just normal. But going forward, I think as an adult now, you know, a person can own up to their past and the role that they played, and they can try to teach their kids that, you know, you can try to teach your kids and show them by example not to make the same mistakes you did, and treat the most vulnerable people with empathy and kindness. I suppose what inspires my art, or what inspired me to be a musician and continue to be an artist, is to create music that touches people and that has an impact on them, to provide them with empathy and to provide value for other people. In other vocations and in other careers, people make things with their hands and they create objects that people can use. We don't do that. So my struggle has been, or what I set out to do, is to create something tangible that touches somebody else. And if they feel that they're understood, or if they feel like they can connect to an experience that I'm writing in a song, that's the payoff for me. My songwriting process, I don't really have one. I do have made peace with the fact over the years that I do much better in a co-writing situation. It helps me stay focused. I tend to be pretty scatterbrained, and it's hard for me to focus and stay on one topic. So when I book a co-write with somebody, it helps to rein that in, and just being able to spitball and bounce things off somebody else, it really works for me. So that's definitely part of my process, I suppose. And I guess another part is I typically look at songs topically. I'll have a topic that I want to address, or something that's important to me, or something that I've experienced, and I'll start there and then kind of build from there. I'll usually start with a guitar hook and then build a melody from there. Having a sense of community and being engaged in the community is, as I get older, I'm learning that it's more and more important, because, you know, it. When you're young, you're focused on yourself and your own pursuits. But as you get older, you realize that you need to give back to others. And sometimes I mentioned before that I had a situation with my health where I was off my feet and I was off work for over a year. My community came together around me and helped prop me up in order to get me through a rough stretch. So that drove home that point that as you get older, at any time in life, belonging to a community and contributing will always make the world a better place.
Thoughts and prayers for the Sin City Strip. Hell rained down from a military clip. No real reason, no cause, no sign, just a room full of guns and an angry guy. Thoughts and prayers, token little deeds, it's all we can do while people bleed. What a life's worth How do you feel, or is your heart just numb like cold blue steel? Oh, 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 oh. Keep doing nothing. Oh, 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 thinking it'll change. And we pass the blame, stick our heads in the sand until it happens again. Thoughts and prayers, do we change this time? If not now, when? If not when, why? When innocent kids are getting shot at school, don't you think it's time for us to change the rules? Oh, 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 we'll keep nothing. Oh, 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 thinking it'll change. Oh, 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 we hide behind freedom. We blame it on the past and we pass the blame. Stick our heads in the sand until it happens again. Time comes, we'll hang it on the sick and we'll hug our guns. When the young rise up and they march in the streets, is the clue right there for you and me? Oh, 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 but keep doing nothing. Oh, 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 thinking it'll change. Past and we pass the blame, stick our heads in the sand until it happens again. Thoughts and prayers, empty blank stares. Thoughts and prayers, devil's crosshairs. Thoughts and prayers.
Thoughts and Prayers was written at a time when I was recovering from a surgery and I was bedridden. I had been locked in bed for months. And on the news, there was a lot of mass shootings in the United States that year, but that happened to be the one in Las Vegas where 58 people died. I knew people who were at the show. I knew people who were working the concert, and it really affected me, as all of them do. And it just made me angry that after taking this information in and trying to process it, I turn on my social media, and I think the biggest outrage that was going on in the chat, in the threads, were the fact that people should dare to talk about changing laws to restrict weapons of war. And that really, really made me angry that people weren't more affected and dismayed by the blood of 58 people spilling in the streets at a concert. So that was kind of where that song came from. And I guess in a nutshell, the dictionary defines the term insanity as the act of repeating the same behavior and expecting a different result. And we wrote the song Thoughts and Prayers with my buddy Rick Norheim from Swift Current. Probably the best advice that I was given was by Ray McGuire, the lead singer from Trooper. And I was pretty young at the time, and I was just starting to experiment with recording songs and thinking about getting my own career going. And I was working a concert, because I work in production. And so after the show, I took him a burnt CD of my songs, and it had a hideous old picture, and I handed it to Ray, and I said, hey, Ray, I hope I'm not disturbing you, but would you mind having a look at this little project that I'm working on? And he grabs a CD and he says, well, if it's a little project, why would I waste my time looking at it? He says, I'll give you a tip. When you're talking about your project and what you're doing, it's the biggest and the greatest thing out there. That's how you got to sell it, because if you don't believe it, nobody else will. And that kind of floored me, because I was, you know, trying to be humble, and that's what he came forth with. And as far as advice that I'd pass along to anybody who wants to get into music or the arts in general, make sure you're doing it for the right reasons. It's a very tough career. It's if you're getting into it for money and fame, that's probably the wrong career to get into. But if you're doing it because it's rewarding and it's a way to express yourself and it makes you happy to get up and go to work, then knock yourself out and go for it. Coming up next for me, that's a tough question. I released an album, as I said, last year in 2020 when the pandemic started. My intention was to tour for 2 years to back it. But right now, with the world being changed, I'm really not sure. I do intend in the next couple of months to kind of turn my focus from promoting to get into the creative headspace and get back to writing. So, because you always have to be looking down, you gotta always be looking down the road. So in the immediate, that's my plan. Not too long ago, I had somebody who was at one of my shows come up to me, and it was a really unique experience. She mentioned one of the songs that I wrote, and it was the one that I wrote about my family and where I grew up. It's called It's a Pride Thing. And she was in tears because she had lost her father a few months before that. And she said, that song describes my dad to a T. How did you know him? And as it turned out, the conversation progressed. And it turned out that her father grew up about 6 miles from my farm. He was north of Dysart and I was north of Cupar, and his dad knew my dad. So they were basically around the same age. So in a way, the song really could have been about her father. So that was a really neat experience, a shared experience that came from one of my songs.